Talk about this title, Crafting an Open Font Stack, because looking at the possibilities that we have now for doing using font face for websites, and I know a lot of developers are here thinking about, well, maybe we can take some of these new fonts and actually put them on the web. But because this is, you know, things are changing, I'm going to actually change the title of my talk. Just edit. This, I think, edit me is the, this is almost the metaphor for where we are now for fonts on the web. So I can just edit this, and I can change the title of my talk to, let's say, collaborative design. Oops. Can't always spell correctly. Okay, new title to talk, collaborative type design in real time. So yesterday we heard from David Klassen talking about the Google Web Fonts. And this is basically, we saw this project launch last year. It's just, as you saw what he talked about yesterday, it's really taken off. And basically created a scenario where now, as designers, as people doing web development, we can have access to these great designs for our web fonts. Even though it's a Google project. And then we heard from our friend Nate. He had released this font news cycle just very, very recently, and it's now available on the Google Web Fonts. So I'm actually going to encourage you to spend a little bit of time looking at this website. Even if you're not a web developer, I think you can learn a little bit about how to use type on the web. So if you can launch up their font viewer, this is a very easy way for you to get a good demo of what these different fonts might look like on the web. So we can say welcome to the graphics team. And it then allows you to preview what this might look like on a website. Now the great thing about this, and this is what I was originally going to talk about, is actually looking at some of the code that you can use to embed in your status sheet to get these fonts on your website. But then looking at what Nate was doing a little bit more, I started asking myself, well, how is he actually developing this font software? Traditionally, I mean, we all went to the printing shop last night. We know that traditionally, font design was a very collaborative kind of initiative. And it wasn't really until digital type came out that it then became not a team of people making a font, but maybe one person. I think now with open source font development, we have a potential to go back to a more collaborative type design. And so if we look at what Nate is doing, well, he's using Launchpad, just like many other open source projects that you can find on Ubuntu or other open source design, open source projects. And this actually allows us to not just use the font, but if we find a problem, we can file a bug. We can say, hey, Nate, there's a problem with your font. You can fix it. Fortunately, there are no open bugs right now against the new cycle. Good thing for him. It's a very, I don't know if that makes an open source developer happy or sad to see no bugs. It's like maybe nobody cares. So this is one possibility, but there are many other possibilities. So the Open Basketball Project, this is a kind of revival type project. They have a website, but they're also using GitHub to manage, collaborate. Fortunately, I think they have more issues here. So we can see that our friend Eric has unfortunately gone back. He's been making some changes to the font. We can actually, on GitHub, we can view all the source code and font. We can actually watch in real time as the font designers will modify the font, make changes, and if we really want, we can also fork the font. So here's my fork. Now this is something that was maybe not possible before in font design, say, well, I can make a copy of your font, I can modify it if I want. I might have to read the license to see if I'm actually, respecting the terms. Like, oh, this is really complicated. follow all this right now, but it tells me some of the rights that I can use for this font. And it basically is opening up the process for how this is done, maybe trying to demystify it a little bit for how are fonts made, it seems so mysterious. So this is using GitHub. It's a proprietary site, even though it's running on Git version control system. If we look at some of our friends at open source publishing, we also have a Foundry, some very interesting fonts. You can go to their website and download these. But if you're really clever, you can also find that, oh, they're also using, they have a Git server running where you can also view the source code for these fonts, pull changes when they have something new, and not just have this looking at the design, but actually looking at all the ugly things that are going on. Kind of like watching pop-downs get made. This is watching fonts get made. So for me, this is actually very inspiring to see. I'm not a font designer. I have amateur interest in it. But if I want to learn a little bit more about how these fonts are made, maybe contribute to how they're made, I know that I can not just download the OpenType fonts or the TrueType fonts, but I can download the source code if they're using something like FontForge, if they're using FontLab, I might have to buy a copy. But I can still get access to source code for how these things are made, and maybe make my own contribution. So I've been thinking a little bit, well, I'm not a font designer, but I wanted to think about, how can I help this movement? What can I do to make this a little bit easier? So, as we saw yesterday from my colleague Brad, I work at a company called Fabricators. This is LGM last year. Maybe soon, I think we're working on the press release today to let more people know about what we're doing here. And one of the things that we're a little bit experienced in is using our software tool, ID Framework, to do collaborative web design. Particularly for community building. So, as our colleague Brad talked about yesterday, OpenClipArt is a project that we've worked on, a very successful way to build a community and get people uploading. And then, in the last few years, there's an idea about doing this for fonts. So we had a little bit of market history of the font library, maybe going back to 2006. The project has kind of gone in fits and starts. But I'm very happy to announce that in LGM 2011, we've relaunched the Open Font Library. I just want to actually walk you through how you can use this, and if you are a font designer, how you can actually upload your font. Maybe we'll try to upload one now. We just launched it, so there's only a very few number of fonts here. Some of them you recognize. Some of them I'm waking up every day now. There's like a new font on there. It's kind of making me happy. Hoping to see more. So we can select it.
Oops.
Server problem. All right. Maybe if somebody wants to call the people at OSU. Okay. Well, you guys can log on. It should be back in a bit. For any of the fonts here. One thing we're doing a little bit differently is that we're allowing you to download a zip file of fonts, but we're also showing you a font-based preview. So all of these fonts that you see on the website are not images, but the actual font file that's been available through the font face in the style sheet. So for any of the fonts, we have this font to our outline. It's kind of new. And one thing that we maybe want some information about the font, such as, well, what languages is this font available for? So for any of these, you can actually get a list here of the languages that it's available for. And what's really cool is we can see we have full language support for basic Latin, Catalan, Afrikaans, even Indian, and on. And here, though, we have partial language support for IPA, which is the International Phonetic Alphabet. Well, if I click on here, I can actually find out what we're missing. So we're missing like the SF, maybe Theta, and then we're missing, we don't even know what that is. But this is one thing this is allowing us to do is looking at places where we might be able to improve the font. It's like, oh, it just needs like three more characters, and then we have full IPA support. Pretty cool, right? So So it's even a way for us to give feedback to the developers. Did you have a question?
I mean, it seems like in this case, we should copy the SF, not Russian European, put it in that code point and submit a patent right now.
Right now? So you mean put it in there and then just have it as a different character?
They both have SF, don't they?
Well, so that what it's saying is that this font does not have the SF.
But it has to be Western
Europe. Beta.
Or it has to be beta. Oh, this is beta.
Oh, that's beta. Oh, never mind.
Who speaks Unicode? So this is a really good point. That's even the kind of thing that even if you're not skilled graphically in drawing the font, if there's something small you can do, like just like this, like, oh, let's just take, hopefully it's the same, similar design. Beta and Essa, I think that is a beta, I think you're right. They're not exactly the same character, though. But maybe on a font like this, it might be close enough to be just a small font. All right, forget it. Okay, so we'll go back and look at the other fonts here. And hopefully we'll get more. So this was like old standard. I just uploaded this one yesterday. It's really quite convenient. With like how many languages it just supports. I think although Ubuntu font is maybe the most. So this has full language support for all of these languages. It has 1,434 glyphs. Pretty good. And it allows you to just download all these font files in one go. This has OpenType and TrueType variants of this, like C Sharp. And you can download it just like this. So these are the fonts. Hopefully, for some of you guys who have a font project like me sitting in the front row, hopefully you can like upload it right now. That'd be great. In real time, maybe we can do a demo. So what I'd like to encourage everybody to do here, if you have your laptop later, is to sign up on the site. And unfortunately, if you're not a font designer, there's not so much you can contribute right now, but I'd actually like to get some feedback from you guys about what might be useful features. So I'm going to have a login. And maybe we can look at this. This is telling me the praise bar. So this is the upload process. It's very, very easy. I'm going to give it a font name. I'm going to give it another computer. And I think this is a display font. So we have some categories here. Serif is on Serif. And then say this is a display. And then we're going to upload the font and see if it works. All right. Uh-oh. Submission rejected. License check. One or more of your fonts did not have a license to be recognized or support. The Open Font Library is a home for quality open fonts. We want all fonts to have a license included inside each font, so it is clear to everyone what their rights are. You must add metadata to the font, embedding a license that is accepted. We have three recommendations, the SIL Open Font License, the GNU GPL version 3 with font protection, or Creative Commons CC Zero license, although there's a much longer list. And our wiki has some information about these licenses. You can visit it, and please try again. Okay. Now, we had to put this in here. It's the Open Font Library, so we want all the fonts to be available under a free license. Now, a lot of software uses this license. One thing that's a little bit different about fonts is we have the possibility to embed the license inside the metadata of the font itself. So if I select one of these fonts, I can see that it actually uses the OFL from Stowe International. And that means if I download this font, I have a very clear idea of what my rights are. We had to do this as a way to protect people's uploading lots of things that might be free, but down the line, we might not know what our rights are and what their rights are. So as a user of the site, you're pretty well protected about knowing that everything on here is under a free license. And if you have like one particular kind of license you like maybe you don't like GNU, okay, you can actually search for which fonts on the site are available under which license. So the last thing you can do, depending on if you like this, is just take each font for a test drive.
Oh my God.
Okay, so any font here, you can just try it out and see if it's something that you like or not. So where do we take it from here? This is kind of what I'm wondering right now. This was just launched, version 0.2. We still have a lot of work to do. We have an old wiki on the site that has a lot of good information, but we haven't yet moved it over. So actually, we're looking for volunteers to help take some of this information, maybe rewrite it a little bit, do some copy editing, and help us get it onto our guidebook, which is only one page right now. And if you find any problems with the site, we also have a Launchpad site for like bug tracking. So we're now tracking it at version 3. And this is a good thing that if you find any problems with the site, just come file a bug and we'll maybe get to it eventually. But mostly what we want right now is we want to get people uploading fonts. We want to get people using fonts, and so we're going to have a way to help you get these fonts onto your websites. But we also want people to join our community, get on the mailing list, use the website, file bugs, give us some feedback about what you guys want, and help us make this a better site. So I'm going to end here. This is we have a little bit of time for questions. So if there are any like font designers, I know we have the OSP people in here. We have the font designer in the second row. But also, if you guys are font users, I'd really like to get some feedback on what would be useful, both from like the design process of doing a font, but also from using fonts, and how, and also about maybe learning about fonts. I like get this site to help you learn a little bit more about font design.
Yeah,
that's
a good question.
Louis?
Yeah,
hi, yeah, this was awesome. Should go back to the, I guess I have two things I'll say. One is that, and the part where you edit, where you can type using the font.
Yeah.
I realize now that I could have always used Firebug inspect element to modify the page. But it's not clear to me that I should be typing where it says, right?
It's not clear, yeah, it's a little bit of an Easter egg.
I mean, and I see it says in tiny text, try some text. But I would love it if that were made
a little bit more obvious.
Like, I mean, you could say, click here to start typing a guidebook, and then that string can process the font.
Okay. Yeah. So you're not the only one who did that. So
okay.
That's a good, yeah, file book.
Okay, I'll look at that. And the other thing is, sort of two things. Is the source for these fonts usually available inside the site? How?
Yes.
What's the mechanism for editing fonts? I actually have no idea.
For editing the fonts?
Yeah, and okay. Similarly, you asked, what can this site help me learn about fonts?
Right.
If there was like a tutorial, like, you can see this font is missing this clip.
And then how to fix it.
Yeah.
I think that's a great suggestion. So if we have a link, I think a good one is to ask the question. Because it's missing like one, it's missing one, or two. So this is a project, the source code is available. And if we look here, it's missing, it has Western European, it's only missing CCDA, which is actually a pretty easy, it's not the hardest to draw. Let's put it down there. It would be something if you're kind of an aspiring type designer. So I think that's a great suggestion. So maybe we should have a link here saying, oh, this is how to fix the font if you want. As for, let's say, the source code, so we're not. One thing that we do require when people upload a font is that we need to have the TrueType or OpenType font in the zip file. Because if it doesn't have the TrueType or OpenType font, then we can't display it. It's kind of useless for the site. One thing we don't require is putting the source code inside the zip file. But what I've seen from looking at the uploads is that I'd say most of them are including this information. So if I download OpenPassRegal, and look inside, I can see that they've included all of the source files inside. So this is something too that it requires, like I open this up, like I have no idea what to do with this. Right? I think most of us are probably in that situation. So I think what we need, and maybe from some of the type designers who are here, help us write a little bit of a guidebook for when you open up the source file, you see all this, you know, like flying like UFOs and glyphs and stuff. What tools do you need? And then how can you actually help make the font? That'd be really, really useful. I think I even learned a lot from that kind of thing. This one I think is, they're probably using FontLab. If you see SFD files, these are from FontForge, which is, but for the projects that are using FontForge, this is a freely available tool that a lot of open font designers are using. Any questions?
Good questions.
I was just wondering how you differentiate yourself from the Google project.
Well, the difference between us and the Google project is that right now we have fewer fonts. But I think it's a longer term trend that we'll have more fonts than Google. The other difference, I think, from what you see on the Google page is that if you sign up to our site and you go to your profile page, we'll ask you to create a font family. And right now, although the Google Fonts project is accepting quite a lot of fonts, they still have kind of a solution policy. It's not anybody can upload the font, which I think is good and bad. It's good for quality control, but it's bad for people who maybe don't have the confidence of their font isn't finished, but they still want to upload it. And I think Google Font Project would not really be the best place to put a font that's not ready, not finished. But for Open Font Library, even if there's one character in there, it might be useful to somebody. We want to create maybe a comment system and rating system, and also help people get feedback from their designs. That's a good question.
Okay. One remark and one question. The website really looks beautiful, but I didn't read the link that you have pressed to get a real information about the code. I would never have guessed that if I had not downloaded it. And the other thing is, I've made a virtual font myself for reading exotic languages like the case used in my password on the management of this book for strange languages, or the Bakhtar, which is an old developed language that's no longer spoken. What category should I put up? It's not display font, it's not Serif, it's just exotic stuff.
Yeah, so this would be a good thing to try to talk about. So those categories were just very, very basic categories. I think as we get more font depots, we'll see we're not covering these categories. Fortunately, if the category you want is not yet available, you'll have a chance later to go back and you can edit which category the font belongs to. So as this list improves, you can see something like that. I think what we also like is getting maybe a more clear list of languages. Like we want to be able to search here. I want to search for all the fonts that they cover more easily. So we want to get a little bit more like search capability here, not just the category. If you have a suggestion, like it's missing something, then please file it by the way. We'll get to it eventually. That's a great question.
So on Google Web Fonts, it supports being able to use the Web Font mechanism in the browsers.
Yes.
Do you plan to support this in Google Web Fonts?
Oh, definitely, yeah. Right now, you can obviously hack it and figure out how to do it. But yeah, we want to have a very easy way to embed the font. The one thing that we're also going to do a little bit different from Google is that we're kind of inspired by the Git version control idea of fonts. And so one thing that we're going to do a little bit differently is, unlike Google, when you visit the font page, what we're actually going to see here is the whole history of every single version that's been uploaded to the site. So if you have some particular version that you want to link to, those links will always be good. And it won't update the font like behind your back. It also means that if you're working with a designer, and your designer says, oh, we're doing a layout, and we're using version 0.2 of the font. Well, what we want is you can visit Open Font Library, you can find that exact version of the font, and not just the latest one. So this is something else a little bit different from what Google's doing. We want to keep it as it is, and not have it just disappear.
Any other questions? Comments?
Something in what you've shown so far that deals with forking.
Right.
Is that
the forking thing is, I think, a little bit difficult for fonts. And part of that is because of this preserved font name. So, I mean, GitHub and these kind of like tutorials are great projects for saying, you know, like, I don't really have, my software is not really released, I just want to like put it up there. I can't use SourceForge because it's not like a real project. I just want to throw something up there, and if it's useful, it's useful, if it's not, it's not. And it also allows people just to experiment, right? So I can fork GitHub. On GitHub, I can fork and I can start changing the font. It's a little bit of a difficulty with a font because there's this thing called reserved font name, which is in a lot of licenses. And that's saying if you modify the font, the one thing you have to do is you have to change the name. And now there's no other like open source project that really has that requirement. Yeah, so there's some trademark things for like Redmap, Firefox, but for a lot of stuff you have a little bit more flexibility. The reason we did this for fonts is that when you pull down your font menu, well, if you have some modified version of the same name, you're going to have a collision, right? And you're not going to be able to tell the difference. So it's a little bit of a usability issue. That's great, you know, for end users, but for developers, it's like, oh, I just want to fix one thing, but I have to change the name. And even if I fork it, to change one thing, like even if I change the README, I guess I should also change the name of the font. You know, it takes a little bit more work to start hashing out things. This was a great example where OSP was running their own Git server. And I think what we want to do is set up an instance of Gitolite so we can have a Git server running on Open Font Library. What we also want to do is allow, if you're using some other repository, instead of doing an upload, what we want to do is just, you can put in the URL for your repository, like a Git URL. And you don't have to upload, you just can have a book. And when you update your font, we'll just pull the newest version. So this is something that's planned for like the next version. Yeah, we want to get like the version control. It's already in there, just not really like, you can't really use it yet. It's not really exposed.
Other questions, comments? We're actually missing the next speaker, so.
Yeah, you could. You could.
When be good to start the discussion on fonts? The next two speakers will be there at 11. That's 25 minutes from now. We may discuss a little bit. Meantime, still one question here.
Hey Chris, what was the software you were using in the beginning? That website that just automatically.
Oh, it's called Big Text. Yeah, it's a JavaScript. What it allows you to do is set, it'll just like match the width, whatever you like width you give it to your text.
Right.
Yeah, so you get those really beautiful like fonts. Like, you used to set that stuff up. It's called Big Text. You can search like Big Text makes text pages. It's pretty easy. There's some really, actually, if I were doing another demo, I took it, all the JavaScript stuff that you can do with fonts, and I was pretty interesting. Big Text was one for doing my plus stuff. You can even like do 3D rotation.
So what stuff do you do right now?
What stuff? Maybe for, I don't know, like who here is doing font stuff? If you wanted to like meet him this afternoon, maybe we could just go back and get together.
Nice.
Any more questions? Or comments?
Find me during the break if you want to like
is that tight pants? Let's have a break.
Yes.